what do you think of when you think of an engineer? Someone who builds cars and bridges? Well, did you know that engineers also create things to make people healthier?
Hi, my name is Diana. I'm a professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute. I'm working on magnetic nanoparticle heating, which has application in cancer hyperthermia.
Diana studies different methods to help people with cancer. To do this, she works with nanoparticles. Nanoparticles are really, really small particles, about 1,000 times smaller than a single cell. The ones Diana works with are also magnetic.
So a magnetic nanoparticle, it's a tiny magnet. They're used to locally generate heat in cancer treatment.
Wow! So these small nanoparticles can generate heat? How do they do that? If we put a magnet near the nanoparticles, they will line up with the magnet. If we want the nanoparticles to move, we can move the magnet, and the nanoparticles will follow. If we want the nanoparticles to move quickly, we can use an alternating magnetic field. The nanoparticles follow the magnetic field and move to always align with it. If the alternating magnetic field moves quickly, so will the nanoparticles. When they move quickly, they start getting hotter and hotter. If they're in the body, this can increase the temperature of the tissue around the nanoparticle, which is called hyperthermia. This can be very helpful when treating cancer. Let's look at an example. This boy has a tumor, but doctors are going to help him by using magnetic nanoparticle therapy. First, the doctor injects the nanoparticles directly into the tumor. Since the nanoparticles are really small, they move randomly around the cells. Now, the doctor puts the tumor in an alternating magnetic field. This makes the nanoparticles move very quickly, and if they move quickly, they will start to get hot, really hot. The temperature can get so hot that the nanoparticles start to hurt the bad cells, and the tumor can shrink over time.
So depending on the duration of the treatment and the temperature rise, the cancer cells can either die or become sensitized to other cancer treatments such as chemotherapy or radiation.
When we send the nanoparticles into the body, we need to add a coating. It's like a hard shell coating that covers the particles. The coating helps the nanoparticle work correctly without hurting any other cells. If you put a bunch of nanoparticles in your body without a coating, they could all clump together. This would be bad because they could clog an area in your body and not get to the right place. So scientists add coatings. They have to pick the right kind of coating that help the nanoparticles go to a specific part of the body that they are trying to help. This makes sure they are working properly, without sticking together to other nanoparticles. Since there are all different types of cells in your body, the nanoparticles are coated differently, depending on the types of cells they are trying to enter. How cool is that? Scientists and engineers like Diana have to be curious and creative to come up with ideas like these that really help people.
It's so much fun to learn new things every day and come up with new ideas. It never gets boring.
In this design challenge, design a magnetic nanoparticle with a coating that can interact all different types of surfaces. Are you ready to make your own coated magnetic nanoparticle? Check out the activity on the Curiosity Machine.